Okay, we're going to figure out the exact values for all the trig functions when the angle is 675 degrees. So be sure you draw a picture and come up with a reference angle and remember the ratio of the sides for the special right triangles. So now let's go ahead, draw the x and y axis. And you know this is more than 360 degrees, right? So be sure when you rotate, keep track carefully. Starting from the positive x axis, and this is positive 675, so you're going to turn this way, right? So let's go right here. This is going to be 360 degrees. It's not enough yet, right? Okay, so I'm going to go from here to here. 360 plus 180, this much right here will be 540. Still not enough, right? And then I will go another 90 degrees from here to here. 540 plus 90, it's 630. We're almost there. We need 45 degrees more, right? So I will go from here, 45 degrees more. So it's just like this, right? This much was 45 degrees, okay? I'm just going to write it like super tiny because this is technically not the reference angle. But anyways, I will have to draw the terminal side from here to here like this for you guys, okay? This is the terminal side. The reference angle is technically from here to here, right? From the terminal side to the x-axis. Well, this much was 45 degrees. This right here should also be 45 degrees, right? Because altogether, they need to add up to be 90 degrees. So the reference angle that we're looking at is 45 degrees. And the purpose of drawing this right here is so that we can squeeze in a special right triangle. And you know you are going to use the 45, 45, 90 special right triangle. And when you draw the special right triangle, put it down this way. So just draw a right triangle here, right? And let me just make a straight line down like this. And now we have to remember the ratio of the sides. Okay, 45, 45. So the ratios right here are the same. So this is going to be 1 and 1, right? Well, in this case, you see that this one is down below. So technically, this will have to be negative 1 because it's down below. It has negative y value. And the r right here, the hypotenuse, is going to be just square root of 2. This right here is always positive, so keep that in mind. All right, so this is what we're going to use. This is the x value, is positive 1. And this is the y value, which is negative 1. And the r is the hypotenuse, which is always positive, and in this case, is square root of 2. And now we can just go ahead and fill the rest. For sine, it's going to be y over r. Y is negative 1, r is square root of 2. So we have negative 1 over square root of 2. And now let's multiply square root of 2 bottom and the top. And we end up with negative square root of 2 over 2, right? And for cosecant, you just do this over that. Square root of 2 over negative 1, which is going to be negative square root of 2. Done. Next, for cosine, is x over r. X is 1, and r is square root of 2. So we have 1 over square root of 2. And you can just go ahead and do this, right? For the cosine version, in this case, it's going to be positive square root of 2 over 2. And for secant, it's square root of 2 over 1. So let's just go ahead and do this, which is square root of 2, positive. At the end, we have tangent and cotangent. Tangent is going to be y over x. So it's negative 1 over 1. And you can just say this is negative 1 altogether. And for the last one, cotangent is x over y, which is 1 over negative 1, and you end up with negative 1. And that's it. So be sure you draw the picture.